Hey girls and guys, I'm Alexia, and today you can see how I set up my filter during the maintenance, so stay tuned. For the Rocky Mountainscape, I am using an Eheim Professional 4600 external filter. This filter I'm using for an aquarium which is approximately around 100 liters. Since I never really maintained the filter since we got the tank, which is around a half year, this is the first big maintenance session of this filter. As you can see, the sponge isn't that clean anymore as it used to be. For cleaning the filter, I'm using only the water from the aquarium. Otherwise, the beneficial bacteria will get killed. So don't forget, never use tap water for this. After removing the sponge, I just take out all the filter cases and put the matrix, the Seachem matrix filter media I'm using, in the aquarium water. This filter media I'm using, you can find the link below to it in the description. Here you can see that I'm removing the filter floss, which is an Eheim filter floss, but if you want to, you can cut it out as well. I won't use this filter floss again. Instead, I will use a new one because this is quite used now. After I emptied all the filter hose from the filter cases, I will start to clean the filter hose. Give it a good wash on all the sides. After cleaning the hose, I will start to clean all the other parts of the filter, so the filter cases. For sure, many would just say that I should leave it like this because of all the beneficial bacteria, but most of the bacteria are still in the filter media, so I give this also a big wash. Don't forget to clean the ceilings as well and all the little edges. I will reuse this blue sponge, this coarse sponge. For this, I will clean it as well. As before said, most of the beneficial bacteria are still not here in. As in all my aquariums, I'm using the Seachem Purigent. How you can maintain this, I will explain you in another episode. The filter media itself, I just rub it in the water a little bit, so the very big particles just float away. Because it's in aquarium water, the bacteria won't die, or not that many of them. After cleaning it, I will start to put the Seachem matrix back to the filter cases. After finishing the first case, I will fill in the second case and the third case. Don't forget to take care of all the cases where just fit good in each other. The refreshed Seachem Purigen I just pour in a media bag after I zip tie it and put back in the third last case. On the top, I put in the new nice filter floss. I push it in gentle and top it and put it back into the filter house. After finishing the filter house, I will start to clean up the rotor house because, as you can see, there is much to do with it. A lot of dirt came over there. I remove the motor. I put all parts out, give it a good wash. Take care not to break anything. With gentle moves, without scratching it, I clean it out. In the inside of the housing, I'm helping myself with a toothbrush. This way I can access all the areas I couldn't in any other way. With every maintenance, I always lubricate all the parts of the rotor and the O-rings. By maintaining it with this Eheim oil spray, you will make your filter always last a little bit longer than usually. So take care of always maintaining the filter parts. On the top of that, I squeeze in the blue sponge I washed out. Put back everything nicely. And top it with the last part. After I close the filter, after I closed the filter, I will clean out all the tubings and the glass parts. Even at the tubing ends, don't forget to lubricate it nicely. For helping myself a little bit, I always sign in the tubings in which direction the water flows. This way, I don't have to think of it and search for the right tubings. After I finish the maintenance, I reinstall the filter under the aquarium. I put back all the glassware on it and enjoy the view of a nice clean filter. I hope you liked this episode. If yes, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. If you're curious for further videos, don't forget to check the playlist for the basic aquarium tutorials. And just below, you can find some other very nice aquarium playlists. I hope to see you soon again. Bye!